All right, let's get to our top story. We have some play-in tournament action. Wizards, Celtics, no Jaylen Brown, but no problem for Jason Tatum in the Celtics. Tatum's game high of 50 was more than Bradley Beal and Russell Westbrook combined. Kemba Walker chipping in with 26 as the Celtics lock up the seventh seed in a series date with old friend Kyrie and the Nets. Winners, losers.
Oh, I look forward to the petty, but we will start with this winner of King of the Lou. And no, it is not one Taylor Twellman. It was all contingent upon the battle between Jason Tatum and Bradley Beal. 50 for Jason Tatum, 20 of which on Bradley Beal, so I'm pretty sure the argument has been squashed. The 2021 King of the Lou is one Jason Tatum.
Right.
Fairly easy, right? Now, the 50-point club, we'll go a little bit further into this 50-point effort because, again, we can't emphasize this enough. Tatum joins an illustrious club with
just
14 makes from the field, by the way. He's just the fourth player in playoff and play-in history to hit 50 on less than 15 shots. But it helps when you get to the line and cash in all 17
does
of
help.
Your free throw attempts. So, free money, baby. Free game, Trev, as well.
You always take that free money.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to be the petty person here.
Yes.
Winner, drama, because Kyrie now gets to face his old team, and we love to see it. We all know what happened when Kyrie went to Boston. He pulled out the stage, and he said he was going to do that for every game. No, he just did it for that one, so I love the fact that the Nets are now facing the Celtics in the first round.
Will he pull out more sage?
I don't think so. Because, no, that'd be too predictable. I don't think he's going to do that, but we'll see what happens.
All right. Well, let's check a look at another game. We got the Pacers taking the sting out of the Hornets Tuesday night to the tune of a 144-117 blowout. Yes, you heard that correctly. This without Caris LeVert. It's the fifth time in their history the Hornets have allowed 140 points in a game. Domantas Sabonis finishing one assist shy of a triple-double. We got some winners here.
I'm going to go winner restricted area. And we saw that in the highlights. They were going crazy under the basket. So for the Wizards and anybody else that's facing this team, shut them down. Don't let them go into the restricted area. They had 64 points. That is the most that they've had this season.
No, it's not as easy as you just made that seem, Christine. Like that feels like a tall order.
Play defense. Just a little bit.
Winner, Dougie McBuckets. That nickname is not one of them. But he is, and shouts to him, 15 points in the first. 14 points in the first 5 minutes. That is the most in the opening 5 minutes of a game in an NBA game this season. He was also finishing with 21 points, 4 of 6 from 3. He was a problem that nobody on the Hornets had an answer for. Now, loser, missing piece, is somebody that may have closed the gap a little bit, but not a whole lot, because Gordon Hayward out with that foot sprain really did contribute quite a bit to the Hornets. Now, they were just above 500 when he was in the lineup, but they were 8-16 when he wasn't, and they were 5 points worse offensively.
Now let's call out, or rather shout out, Phoenix Suns coach Monty Williams, who has been voted the National Basketball Coaches Association Coach of the Year. In his second season in Phoenix, Williams resurrected the franchise, leading the Suns to a 51-21 regular season record, the number 2 seed in the West, and their first division title since 2007.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.